接下来看跟俄罗斯相关的消息，这次是民生经济蛋价狂飙。这两年来，俄罗斯侵略乌克兰，因此遭到西方的经济制裁，它的通膨非常高，一年里面蛋价涨了60%，出现了各种挖苦缺蛋的影片。不过呢，对于一个月只有台币4600元的俄罗斯退休族来说，蛋价这么高，日子非常难过。为了稳定内需，总统普京这次新年谈话里面第一次向民众为蛋价失控道歉，而且采取的做法是免除鸡蛋关税半年，赶快从土耳其等各国增加进口。三月要举行总统大选，这个执政24年的普京呢，毫无疑义的，他会以无党籍的身份，他已经选择参选了，铲除了所有的竞争异己，几乎笃定会连任再做6年。
俄乌战争即将届满2年，西方经济制裁的效力开始渗入俄罗斯老百姓的生活当中。近日鸡蛋价格不断飙升，光是去年12月就涨了18%。网友拍各式影片挖苦现状，像是鸡蛋成了丈夫宠妻大礼，太祖收到好开心。还有许多网友成了鸡奴，为珍贵的蛋鸡提供美容服务。不过缺蛋问题对每月只有150美元退休金和台币4600元的长者来说，很难一笑置之。
Of course, we notice it. The pension is 13,000 rubles, says Lyubov. Maybe we buy less meat, says Nadezhda. There's still enough for medicines.
俄罗斯年通膨率为7.4%，光是蛋价一年就涨了60%。超市外大排长龙，都是要买限量鸡蛋。总统普京在新年谈话中坦承蛋价失控，公开向
I am sorry about this and want to apologize for this problem. This is a setback in the government's work. Although they say this is not the case, I still think it is.The problem is related to a failure to increase imports enough.
俄国政府宣布免除鸡蛋关税6个月，从土耳其、亚塞拜然和白俄罗斯增加进口。普京还公开向白俄罗斯总统卢卡申科讨蛋。
Our own production covers our needs in terms of grain, pork, chicken, milk, vegetable oils, and chicken eggs.
Send some to us. Don't be greedy.
俄罗斯的经济没有因为战争而转冷，国内需求强劲，薪水不断调涨，推升了物价。普京吹嘘俄罗斯的经济抵抗力强，却对背后的成因隐而不谈。俄罗斯因为严重缺工才导致薪水调涨。经济专家认为，普京动员大量年轻人到前线打仗是导致缺工和通膨的主因。
Mobilization.I think to me the key issue here is the fact that there are a lot of deaths at war and then they have to be replaced. These people have to be replaced. You know, the Russian officials trying to keep it very quiet, the numbers of how many people have died.
俄罗斯三月即将举行总统大选，执政24年的普京再次以无党籍身份参选。他缴交超过30万份联署书后，周一选举委员会宣布他登记为候选人。普京已经铲除了所有反对党对手，几乎笃定连任，再做6年。
Конечно, большая честь.получить, а затем передать удостоверение кандидата в президенты Российской Федерации Владимиру Владимировичу. И в самое ближайшее время я это сделаю.
西方经济制裁不但对俄罗斯效果有限，延迟对乌克兰的援助还成为俄军的助力。俄军已经识破了乌克兰炮弹短缺问题，近期加强攻击，节节进逼防线。
The situation is very active and very tense, he says, because the enemy has much more equipment and manpower. Basically, every day they try to storm the positions.
乌军表示，他们最害怕的不是俄军的飞弹和无人机，而是致命的坦克车攻击。
They shoot direct fire. Planes are flying. Basically, they have it all, he says.But probably the worst are tanks. When they fire, you don't even hear it. You hear an airplane when it comes over. With a tank, you're in God's hands.
CNN 记者在东部前线采访时，坐车遭俄军无人机锁定，成为炮弹瞄准的目标。
We're now trying to make our way out of here as safe as possible. That means we have to keep distance between our cars, but we also, of course, have to keep moving the entire time to make sure that we can get out of here, hopefully, safely.
美国的援乌预算在国会卡关，一直扬言要退出北约的前总统川普再次入主白宫的可能性升高，北约警觉不能再倚靠美国。北约评估，俄罗斯可能在俄乌战争结束五年内再度侵略北约国家。上周，北约举行自冷战以来最大规模军演，共出动了90,000军力，要测试成员国的应对实力。北约表示，将在未来几年加强东部防线的实力。TVBS 新闻综合报道。